Ivanhoe, Ivanhoe. Overvaart gaan wij te paard met Ivanhoe. Waar hij gaat of staat, we zijn steeds aan zijn zij. We zijn paraat en zingen vrij en blij. Ivanhoe, Ivanhoe. Overal door bos en dal met Ivanhoe. De vrijheid is een leuze, gerechtigheid in het land. Het is voor hem geen keuze, zijn zwaard is in zijn hand. Kom, we gaan, al de zaan. Voluit met Ivanhoe.
Sir Ivanhoe approaches. We must take him prisoner. He's a brave warrior, so use caution. Sir Ivanhoe, Brotherwood.
I am Sir Ivanhoe. And who stops me thus on the open highway?
We are the men of Sir Maurice of Mullinsford.
Has Maurice sunk so low that he now leads a band of brigands and thieves?
Lance is at rest. We have no quarrel with you, sir. When Sir Maurice heard of your return from the Crusades and the Holy Land, he detailed us to meet you and bid you come talk with him.
His invitation is a forceful one. Where is he?
Our overnight camp is nearby. Follow me.
Welcome, Sir Ivanhoe. I'm most happy you're here. You may leave.
The choice was not mine, Sir Maurice.
I did bid you visit me in rude manner, but these are rude times. With no king on the throne, the highways are infested with thieves and robbers. The nobles are warring one with another, and even the serf becomes restless and unruly. We have desperate need of a king. And now?
We have a king. Richard the Lionheart.
But we've had no word of Richard since he was taken prisoner in Europe. He may be dead.
Not King Richard. It is with good reason the people call him the Lionheart. He will return.
Will he? When? How much longer must we watch the country going to wreck and ruin? Prince John has summoned all the thanes and nobles of the realm to convene at his castle, where measures will be taken for our well-being. Your father, Sir Cedric, will be there. And his ward, the fair Lady Rowena.
If King Richard's devoted brother, Prince John, is plotting to steal the crown, he'll get no support from Sir Cedric. Or me.
We ask that you ride with us.
If I go to Prince John's, I shall ride with my father, Sir Cedric. Not with men disloyal to King Richard.
Very well. We meet at Prince John's.
Good day, Sir Maurice.
Have mercy on the lad, sire. In God's name, don't beat the boy.
Stand aside, you have a taste of the whip yourself.
Cut him down.
No, sir. Sir Maurice has ordered that... Summon Sir Maurice!
Thank you, sir. Abdal, is he safe?
Abdal?
He found her in a field with a broken wing. She was just a fledgling, but he nursed her back to health. She loves him, and she understands every word he speaks to her.
A serf has no right to have such birds.
Is that why Sir Maurice ordered him whipped?
His lordship wanted to kill Abdal, but he's too clever to be caught. He ordered me to kill him. I couldn't.
Who are you, boy?
They call me Bart. This is my father, Gurr. Don't let Sir Maurice take you prisoner. Run!
Run? I run well when I run toward something. But I never did learn how to run away.
You two, come with me.
Sir Ivanhoe, you presume too much when you interfere with my administration of justice.
Justice is an odd name for beating a boy.
In my domain, I rule as I see fit.
Very well. Strike off these yokes. I'll pay the customary fee for their freedom.
My serfs are not for sale. Challenge me to combat?
I do. For the freedom of these two and a good mount for each of them.
You claim all this if you should win.
If I lose, I am your prisoner, sir. Compliment, sir, your sword.
Dismount. Do as he says.
I claim good mounts for these freedmen.
Bring two horses!
Sir Maurice, you have given us good cause to doubt your chivalry. Order your men to unsaddle their mounts.
Unsaddle your horses!
Graven images. Saddle your horses and after them.
further, sir.
No, not too far. Are you tired, Bart?
Oh, no, sir.
Good lad. We'll be in Rutherwood soon. And within those walls are friends, good food and rest.
And none too soon, my lord. Look!
On the gallop, lads.
That's his call. Lower the drawbridge, quickly.
Lower the bridge, men. Now put your backs into it.
You say my father left for Prince John's castle yesterday?
With Lady Rowena and five of our men as guard.
Fair Rowena. Take care of these freedmen, Geoffrey. I ride to Prince John's. Order a guard to accompany me. As many men as can be spared.
That I cannot do, Sir Ivanhoe.
You're still steward of Rotherwood, are you not?
Yes, heaven forgive me.
Tell me, old friend, what is amiss here?
You wounded your father deeply when you left in the crusade against his will.
I was old enough. I knew I could give a good account of myself in the war to save the Holy Land.
Sir Cedric did not think so. After your departure, he called together the people of this domain. Know you, he said, the son I loved and cherished is no longer my son. No longer is he welcome in this castle. Henceforth, I forbid you to speak his name in my presence.
I must see my father. I shall ride to Prince John's. Alone, if need be.
Your life is in danger if you ride the highways alone.
We shall ride with him. Hey, Father?
Aye. Not on the highways, but through the woods. Bart and I know those paths as well as I know this hand.
Here is your squire, and there's your armorer. The finest blacksmith in the land.
If we could serve you, sir, I would forge you weapons as have never been seen before. A sword as light as a feather, yet so strong and sharp it'll cut through steel.
What say you now, steward? Is this not a company fit for any adventure?
Very well. Go if you must, but rest the night here and leave refreshed.
So be it. Tomorrow we three ride to the meeting of nobles at Prince John's. Bring on the food. We're a hungry company here.
It is 3 years since my brother Richard led a crusade to the Holy Land. And it was a noble cause he served. Yeah.
Yeah. But the men he led have returned home. And with no word from Richard, many of us feel that he may be lost to us forever. Without a king to guide and rule our land, no domain is secure, no man safe.
As Richard's brother and successor to the throne, I call upon you, his liegemen, to decide.
Shall we wait idly for Richard's return?
Or shall we crown a new king? One who will give us peace
and permit us to prosper again. Prince John, by your leave.
My lords and ladies, Sir Cedric, your brother, would ask leave to speak.
Take care.
My lords and ladies,
are your sons returned from the crusade yet?
An odd question from you, Sir Cedric. Your son, Sir Ivanhoe, is home. I saw him but yesterday.
This is news to me. And you will soon hear such news of King Richard. For he is alive and he will return.
Would you give his crown to Prince John for the asking?
We have all sworn loyalty to King Richard. It was an honorable oath. Stand by it. I, for one, will have no part in a meeting that plots treason to my king. I and my ward are leaving.
I urge you all to do the same. Come, Rowena.
My lords and ladies!
When mad dogs bark, wise men bolt their doors. Let us decide the future of our land with wisdom, not with passion. Prince John has asked you here for counsel to improve our welfare. I urge you to be seated.
Be seated!
Well done, Maurice. Sir Cedric was a good knight, but he grows old and troublesome.
His time would be better served in my dungeon, I think.
That it would. And I shall feel obliged to reward his captor with his domain, Rotherwood.
It is indeed a rich prize, my liege.
For the man who earns it.
I shall earn it, my lord. I will ride to take them prisoner before the day is out.
My lords and ladies,
if we may continue.
Sir Cedric and Lady Rowena approach. Take them prisoner, but don't harm them.
There is no yoke on me. I'll evermore go with the knight Ivanhoe, the hero who set me free. So heroically set me free. Where's Abdul?
I don't suppose he could stand your singing.
I'll go and find him.
Sir Cedric, in the name of Prince John, I claim you and Lady Rowena are prisoners. Do you yield?
I shall never yield to traitors.
Put him in irons.
Taken Sir Cedric and Lady Rowena prisoner.
How many men does he have with him?
At least 20.
This is Prince John's work.
I knew my father would not support his effort to steal the crown from King Richard. What can we do, sir?
Well, we shall need help to free them. Back to Rotherwood.
You stay in command here, Geoffrey. We daren't leave the castle unguarded.
You hope to rescue Rowena and Sir Cedric with 5 men against 20.
We are 8 men. And armed with a plan.
Bart, Kurt.
You have your tools ready, Girth?
Aye. And this is my anvil.
Good. There are 20 men with Maurice. Those odds are too great. Now, on my signal, cut the rope holding the two trees. That should divide his force in half, making the battle more even. We'll attack Maurice and the rear group. I'll send Sir Cedric and his men to you. Strike off their chains quickly. We'll need their help.
Thank you.
Ready? Take your men over there. Have your train struggle.
These many years.
Thank you, Father.
Would that I could remain.
What is this? I don't understand.
Urge him to reconsider and stay here with us at Rotherwood.
It's what I dreamed of most during the Crusade, being here at Rotherwood with the two people I love most. But Prince John will not rest until he has taken Richard's throne, and Sir Maurice lusts for Rotherwood. Throughout the land, the people know only hardship and injustice. Would I be true to the vows of my knighthood if I took my ease here?
He is right, Rowena. We have no choice but to let him go.
Bide your time, Rowena.
I'm learning to. You teach me well, my lord.
Farewell, my son, and God be with you.
Ah! Ivanhoe, Ivanhoe. Op vervaart gaan wij te paard met Ivanhoe. Waar hij gaat of staat, we zijn steeds aan zijn zij. We zijn paraat en zingen vrij en blij. Ivanhoe, Ivanhoe. Overal door bos en dal met Ivanhoe. De vrijheid is een leuze, gerechtigheid in het land. Er is voor hem geen keuze, zijn zwaard is in zijn hand. Kom, we gaan, al te samen.